Hello everybody and welcome back to Analog Vernacular. Today we're going to be playing some more Kingdom Come Deliverance, and we might be finishing up this DLC, A Woman's Lot. We're going to be following Tinker here. Also, we need to put some clothes on. There you go. Putting on her dancing dress. All right, I'm with you, Tinker. All right, we can put that away. I'm with you, boy.
Why are you shouting here? You'll bring those heathens.
I have to get out of here and find the others and warn them.
How did you survive the attack?
I hid at the top of the hill and stayed there until it got dark and the screaming stopped. The Hall of Skelets was in flames.
I know. I saw it too.
I wanted to go to Talmberg to warn them, but when I was climbing down in the dark, I lost my footing and went rolling down like a sack of charcoal. I'm black and blue all over.
You're injured. Can I do anything to help?
Something's wrong with my leg. I twisted it when I fell. I managed to limp here to this path, but now I'm all done in.
Did you see any other survivors?
I saw a few people in the distance, but I didn't want to risk shouting to them. There are still a lot of enemy soldiers around. You might run into some of our neighbors.
Let me have a look at that leg. Maybe I can manage to set it.
All right. But please, be careful.
It seems you were lucky. It doesn't look like anything's broken. If there was, the skin would be turning blue by now. Keep that leg raised for a while. And when you go, try not to put too much weight on it. Find a branch or a stick to lean on.
All right. Thanks. I reckon I can manage to get up now. But would you help me as far as the road? The going will be easier there.
I'll help you. Lean on me.
Okay.
I'll manage it from here. But which way should I go?
Go to Talmberg, like the others, and tell them what happened here and to send help.
All right. I won't forget your kindness. But what are you going to do now?
I'll go to the castle to see if anyone survived there.
If you're not afraid to go there, you could look around the small holdings near Skelets or the mine works. People took cover wherever they could when the raid started. May God watch over you, Teresa.
Okay, let's take a look at our map. So, I mean, I wonder if going here would automatically do the Henry stuff, and that would, like, maybe end the DLC. We're gonna do the optional stuff. So, yeah, let's go and look for survivors in each of these areas. See, this was Johanka's house, right? Okay, I would love it if I was able to find that a bad guy?
Who's there? What's going on there? What have we got here? Entertainment? Great.
Man, I hate how long it takes to do any of that shit. Like, I was holding the button to do that, and she didn't even get anything put into that bow. Fuck me, right? Alright, I need to just stop with the bow. I'm not good enough with it. It takes too long for me to switch. They're almost always gonna reach me before I can switch back to a weapon that I won't die with.
I'll manage it from here.
Yeah. Shut the fuck up. Let's go and kill this guy. Man, this game can seriously. Really? Do I have to sick him? Oh my god. The one time when the dog attacks when you would want to actually, like, get a hit in, half the time it doesn't even work. It's so frustrating. Like, what is the fucking point if half the time you can't do anything? No, you think I'm gonna let you survive? You can get the fuck out of here, bro. Screw this guy. Okay, good dog.
There's a good... That's my... Look what you'll love.
What the hell are cracklings? Pork cracklings, huh? Whoops. Fuck you. I'm salty, dude. I need to chill out. This DLC is, like, the last episode got me in such a bad mood. And I really shouldn't be in this bad of a mood. I should pull it together. We don't want to give the dog anything that's rotten. I'll just get rid of that. Already at 75 health, that's a great place to be. With limited supplies. I almost want to turn off the button for the console. It's too close to escape, and we use escape a lot. I feel like I need to look around simply because I absolutely need Savior Schnapps. Alright, whatever. Okay, so I think the dog is still in search mode, yeah? Maybe you can lead me to some savior schnapps. Wouldn't that be lovely? Okay, so this is our place. Okay, well, whatever he's finding, let's hope it's good, because it's kind of taking us off course. It's a nest. Okay, that's not that promising, honestly, but... Okay, Tinker, you gotta fucking move, girl. Boy. I keep on thinking it's a... I mean, that's not even useful to me right now. Whenever I hear the name Tinker, I think of Tinkerbell, so... I always think it's a girl. Lead me to anybody who might be alive, Tinker. Or save your schnapps. Those are the only two things I care about right now, okay? You leading me to this chest? Yeah. Save your schnapps. Of course, then once we have it, we have to figure out when the smart time is to use it. Cool. Somebody in there? Okay, I don't think... Anybody who's just freely walking around is probably a bad dude. Jarmilla. For a second I thought it was Johanka.
What are you doing here? How come you didn't play like the others?
I can't. There's one of those bastards creeping around out there.
What? Where did you see him? The army has pulled out and moved on.
He must be a deserter. He keeps looking around here for what he can steal. And he looked like he was pretty drunk.
You must help me. You've got to get rid of him. Otherwise, I'll die here.
And how am I supposed to get rid of this deserter? Kill him? He's an armed soldier.
You could try lying in wait for him and catching him by surprise. He keeps wandering around here looking for something.
Have no mercy on him. He didn't either.
Do you know if anyone else survived?
I don't know, Teresa. They killed William. He tried to run. But they had horses and they...
That's all right, Jarmilla. I understand. Pa and Stibor and Sammy. They didn't make it either. I'm left all alone.
Oh, you poor lass. How can God allow such things?
I'm not going to let anyone else die. I'll help you. Just wait here, and I'll come and tell you when it's safe to leave.
All right. Thanks, Teresa. And be careful.
Vedel jsi básny a pičába hodíš roto a plavím teď.
Every fucking time, huh? Man! I'm gonna get frustrated every time. Because those swings should have landed. Dog, are you gonna help or what? Okay, no, health is doing okay. I'm trying to save that. I think it's the Lazarus that does like 100 HP over time. I'm trying to save that until I really need it, but like at the same time, dude. One bad fight and we're dead. And we have to do it all over again because we cannot save right now. So frustrating. Can you get me a savior, Schnapps? I would love that, girl.
About fleeing.
Please?
You've nothing to fear. I dealt with that deserter.
Oh, thank God. I thought I'd never get away from here alive. Thanks, Teresa. If you hadn't turned up, I'd be done for sure.
That's all right. Go to Tomberg and tell the people there what's happened. I'll have a look around for other survivors.
Man, I could really use some shit. Just saying. All right, 99 obedience is pretty good still. Okay. Let's see. There's got to be some shit in here. I mean, there's lots of food. Okay, well, it is what it is. I'm gonna end up having to redo all of this because I'm gonna have one bad fight. Like, you all have seen how quickly a fight can go to shit. I'm so nervous. I'm on the verge, like, with this DLC might be the thing that puts me over the edge to get the mod that allows you to save whenever you want. Truly, I hate nothing more than wasting my own time and having to redo content. Just because I can't save during a hard part of the game, like, I don't know, man. I don't know. I've been holding off, and I'm gonna continue holding off until I hit my last straw. Because I know that there's gonna be a subset of my viewers who will not want me to bypass Savior Schnapps, but... I don't know. We'll see. At least they're making the enemies here relatively easy to dispatch, considering how weak she is and that she can't wear any armor. Okay, not a person banging on a wall. Oh, we're not even in the area yet. It's a little further in. That spooked me, though. I think I can hear somebody yelling in the distance. Yep. That guy? Yeah, I think so. Stop yelling, bro. Yo, speak to me, Marash.
Are you mad shouting like that?
Well, I have to find Pavlena. She got lost when we were running in the night.
It's still not safe here. Shouting like that is asking for trouble.
But I have to find her. I can't leave without her. Will you help me?
Where did you see her last?
In the woods here. We were hiding from those demons. I didn't think they'd come here, but when it was getting dark, they found us.
Ooh, she's probably gone. Oh no, she might be dead.
We surprised them as much as they did us. We started to run and it was horrible. One arrow missed me by a hair. I thought I was done for. I ran and then I found myself alone. I lost those bastards, but Pavlena too. I have to find her.
I think we're searching for a body.
What was Pavlena wearing?
The same as always. A blue dress, and she had a scarf on her head.
Blue dress, scarf.
You should keep your voice down. There could still be cutthroats within earshot.
But I've got to find Pavlena. I've got to help her.
All right, we'll see what we can do. Is that a boar? It is a boar. I think boars sometimes will charge you, so I'm gonna stay away from him. Okay, for a second I thought there was a person there in beige, but it's just the end of logs. Okay. Okay, the dog should be able to help, I would think. In fact, you seem to be searching for something. Let's follow you right now. Sure, why not?
That's a good boy.
I feel like that's gonna happen a lot, trying to loot and getting the dog
that's
instead. But hey. Man, lead me to something good, bro. No shade, but a little shade. This is where I actually need you to be searching. Yeah, I have to assume the dog will help us find it when we get somewhat close, but we'll keep an eye out just in case. Let's make sure. You are in searching mode. You should be.
Let's see what seek.
Where's the area? Okay, now we're back in it. Right. I doubt she's alive, but hey, we can hope. Take us to her, Tinker. Okay, bunch more boars. Oh no, yeah, she definitely didn't make it. Damn it.
This must be that Pavlina that Meroš was looking for.
Oh, I'm sorry, buddy. Dude, he's still out there screaming. Why are you being so dumb? Why is he being so dumb? We told him not to keep screaming, that we'd help him. Bro. Fucking shut up. I'm gonna kill you myself.
About Pavlina. I found her.
You did? Where? Why isn't she with you?
Bro is thick, huh?
I'm sorry, but...
I'm not gonna lie to him.
She's dead. They must have caught up with her when they were chasing you.
Oh, no, no, no. My Pavlina. I should never have left her like that. I thought she was right behind me. Jesus, what am I going to do?
You should flee and save yourself, at least.
I don't know what to do now. Where can I go?
Go to Tomberg and tell them everything. Sir Divish will send help and... And then we'll come back and bury our loved ones. I promise.
I wonder if doing this DLC will somehow, like, decide if these...
Other survivors.
How and in what way some of these characters will show up in the main game or something.
Oh, God. Take this. Maybe you'll come across someone who needs it. God be with you.
Like, I wonder if now Henry can run into some of these people that were saved by her or helped by her. Okay, boy. One of these days, you're gonna lead me to save your schnapps, and I'm gonna pet you so hard. I think you're just leading me to bees, but that's okay. You're doing your job. Just hoping and praying one of these days. That we'll get some schnapps. I mean, the further on we get, the more nervous I get, because then it's even worse. I'm guessing you can probably use the console to give yourself Savior Schnapps. And honestly, for this DLC, I'm kind of thinking about doing it. Like, we don't have the options of freedom in this right now, which is really concerning. Alright, looking at people, like, you never know, like, is... He doesn't look like a human. Doesn't mean he isn't, like, a bandit, though. He seems...
Where is it? Cutter! Cutter!
You cool, bro?
They're everywhere! Everywhere!
Woodcutter Julian?
Is it you? Don't be afraid. It's me, Teresa. Are you all right?
Everywhere. They're everywhere. Where is it? Where is it?
You're one of the woodcutters, aren't you?
Yes. Yes. Cutter. Where is it? Quick! They're everywhere!
Julian, you're not making any sense. Where's what? I don't understand you.
Cutter. Woodcutter. They're everywhere! I need it!
Oh my god!
Yeah, dude's lost it. Come on, get your shit together. What
happened here?
Chill out, bro.
Did anyone else survive?
They came. From everywhere. Everywhere. Where is it?
How did you survive? You were left here amongst... Amongst all these bodies?
Everywhere.
Listen. If you stay here, they might come back and kill you. You wouldn't want that, would you?
No! Cutter! Where is it?
This is going nowhere. You've got to get out of here, Julian. Pull yourself together.
No. They're everywhere. Cutter!
Okay, he's clearly looking for something.
Listen to me, and listen well. A short while ago, they killed my little brother. And before that, Pa and Stibor. I'm not going to let anyone else get killed if I can help it. So for Christ's sake, pull yourself together and get out of here before I slap some sense into you.
I can't. They're everywhere. I can't go without it.
Can't go without it.
This is hopeless. How am I going to get through to you?
I think there's an implication that either I need to find something or I need to punch this guy. I might honestly need to beat this guy up. Anybody else getting oh, Julian's axe. Oh, is this what you're looking for, bro?
No. Where is it?
Dude, it took me like 2 seconds, bro.
Julian, pull your...
Here's your axe.
That's what you were looking for, right? Now you'll be safe.
Cutter! Yes! My cutter!
Good, Julian. And now, get to Tomberg. The others are already on the way there. Run like the devil and don't look back.
This man is shook.
Tomberg. Yes!
Took me all of 2 seconds to find his axe. I know, me too, Tinker. Me too. Gotta keep looking for the schnapps. Don't think I'm gonna find any, but have to keep trying. Alright. If there's a fight here, I may use some items to try and hedge my bets. Because we've come a long way. This is the last locale. And I'd hate to lose it at this point, you know? I hear people. It doesn't sound friendly either. Ooh, okay. What does this do? Prevents a hangover, cures alcoholism, charisma is reduced by 2 for 1 hour. Makes your mornings easier. Gotcha. Hair of the dog. Okay, so it's like a hangover thing. Padfoot. Lockpickings, pickpocketing, stealth, increased by 5 for 10 minutes. And then the Lazarus potion, this one will heal us. Over 5 minutes. Hold on, what's the preserver? God damn it. Freshness of food by 50% keeps food fresh for longer and can turn rotten products into edible ones. Oh, okay. Didn't even know that was a thing. Okay. If we die here, I have to do everything again, so... I am very nervous.
Damn this fucking door!
Okay.
Master Potter? What in the name of God are you doing here?
I'm trying to get into my goddamn house!
What for? You ought to flee like everyone else.
I've got coin hidden there. I'm not going to just walk off and leave it. Listen, maybe you could help me. I've heard you mill people know how to deal with these kind of things.
I mean, what are you implying?
What are you implying? That I'm a thief?
Come now, don't play the innocent. We all know your father is no saint. You must have learned some secrets of the trade from him, no?
My father is dead.
Oh, Jesus. Sorry, lass. I didn't know. I'm sorry.
A little bit of tact goes a long way, bro.
Why can't you unlock the door? Don't you have the key?
Of course I do. That is, I did, but I lost it. I was bringing firewood from the woods. Just as I got to the footbridge, I saw that huge army. I dropped everything and ran home as fast as I could. I must have dropped that blasted key on the way.
How did you manage to survive?
I hid out on top of the haystack until morning. Those Edens were sniffing around, but something disturbed them and they ran to the village.
It's still not safe here. Coin is no use to a dead man. You ought to flee to Tomberg while you can.
And leave my life savings to pillagers and footpads? Not a chance.
Where do you think you might have dropped the key?
I'm not sure. It must have been somewhere along the path from the woods. After I passed the footbridge, I was carrying firewood when the raid started. I dropped everything and ran. The key must have fallen on the way.
All right. I'll try and get that coin for you, but I can't promise anything. Where is it hidden?
This damn door is as solid as a rock. All right. Once you get inside, go to the pantry on the left. There's a sack of apples in there, and the purse is hidden right at the bottom of it. Get it and bring it to me. Meanwhile, I'll keep watch here.
Ha, very easy. All right, we're not going to go and find that key, please. I guess for some people, if they broke their lockpicks, they would have no other choice, but... Alright, he said left in the pantry, but obviously we're gonna go and look elsewhere as well. We're also gonna hope for some schnapps. I don't think we need that, right? No. That would just overstuff us.
Full of grosh in here, and a pretty heavy one too.
Cut the horseshit. Strip off. Gone.
Dear God.
So I think that's the issue, is sometimes when I pull out my bow, I push and hold the button to start pulling back, but it won't actually start doing that until you finish your pull-out animation. Yeah, that's a little frustrating, actually, because there's not a clear indication of when that animation is done, when it's going to allow you to start pushing the button to try and pick some of that stuff, or try and... you know, knock your first arrow. You're welcome.
My God Almighty. With all the horror that's going on, he wouldn't have thought twice about killing us on account of money.
People can be swine. They see a corpse and come swooping down like carrion crows. You shouldn't feel bad about it. He got what he deserved.
Take the money. Take it and go to Tomberg. Warn them there and tell them to send help. I'll have a look around the village for survivors.
I'll do that. Take care of yourself, Teresa.
Alright. In the next game, I hope they fix this, like... They basically are invincible when they're pulling out their weapon. There's certain times when they have basically iframes that they really, really should not. So I hope that they fix that in the next game. It's one part of the system that definitely needs a cleanup. Alright. I've been using a club this entire time. Are we capable of using this? Minimum strength 3. We're at 4. So yeah, we could use this new spiked club. Good. Okay. Okay, I'm coming, boy. I'm coming. You show me what you found. When they do that, it seems like they're supposed to be digging something up, but then we never get anything from it, so... I wonder if that's just like... Sometimes the dog finds something for him. And it's really nothing. Okay. Well, let's get into town and hope that we don't have a major fight on the way in that might make us have to redo literally everything that we've done so far. You know, since I can't save. Okay. Yes, I think going around the front. We have to enter from the front, it looks like. Oh, game saved. Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Honestly, that's very kind. I was getting really, really stressed. Tinker, don't... You're gonna get yourself killed, dog. No!
Fuck off!
I don't want to watch this. That is the most upsetting thing that's happened in this game so far. I don't even care about Henry's vengeance. I want vengeance for Tinker right now. Let me kill this guy. Let me kill this guy. Oh my god. My dog is currently sitting next to me. I would raise a town if somebody did that to my dog. I would burn them to the ground. Okay, if this guy is part of that same group, then Henry's vengeance is our vengeance. Therefore, the main goal of the game is now accurate to my intentions. Yep, he is one of those guys. Okay. Henry's vengeance is my vengeance. We are aligned.
I've had enough of you. Hey, goat fuckers!
What a line.
I don't know what to say.
You don't have to say anything. You've been through it yourself. I know you understand.
There's something else I'd like to ask. Remember how we were sore about it? The next morning, Ma scolded me on account of that scratch on my hand.
Oh dear, sorry about that.
That's all water under the bridge now. I never told her it was you who did it. I just wish you could have covered my back too. She was angry that I was at sword training instead of working in the forge. And she said you told her. Your pa and Stibor were really
stupid. No, we hid it. We didn't tell her.
Jesus.
We hid that from her.
I didn't think even Fritz and Matthew would take that kind of chance. And there's not much that pair won't do for an easy grosh.
That wasn't accurate to the choice that we made.
In a way, I can understand that Pa did it for us, but it was really irresponsible. You won't tell anyone, will you?
I won't, I promise. So what happened to the silver?
Pa handed it over, as always, to that slimy fellow. And he took it away. What happened to it then, I don't know.
Yeah, man, because we, as her, we definitely did not tell her mother that. I mean, hold on. Maybe that was about something else? No, we didn't. We didn't snitch, right?
Your pa really wanted to marry you off to Master Tobias?
Yes. Can you believe it?
And have you spoken to Master Feyfar since... since the raid?
I haven't. Either he's lost interest, or he's forgotten about me. Not that I'm complaining. Uncle Peshek would be happy to marry me off too, especially if there was something in it for him. I'm glad that's in the past.
Aye, I don't blame you. So Johanka and Matthias finally got together. Well, if it hadn't been for everything that happened afterwards, who knows? They could be headed for the altar. Probably just as well you didn't play along with Johanka's harebrained scheme and found a better solution. Matthias would have had a fit if he'd lost his favorite dice. Bianca told me something about your little expedition to the woods. She was flaunting that ring all day. I was worried for a while that she had some other suitor who gave it to her.
No, no. Unless you can count a magpie.
Bianca, you really ran into a wolf. I thought Bianca must have been imagining things.
Not exactly. It was actually a wild dog, but Paul used to say those are even worse than wolves.
It's a good thing you were there with Bianca. Going back to help the survivors, that was very brave of you. When I went back to Scalitz, I met no one but footpads and cutthroats. If you hadn't come along, I doubt I'd be here to tell the tale.
You know what our parish priest always used to say? Without Christian charity, we'd all soon be dead. I couldn't just leave you all to your fate, could I? Any good Christian would have done the same.
Well, I'm not so sure. Not everyone has your courage. Did you go back to Scalitz again to bury your pa and your brothers?
Yes, along with some more of our neighbors. We had an escort from the Ratai garrison, with Sir Hanish's kind permission.
Where are they buried?
Sammy's buried near the mines. He didn't like the mines. But his grave is on the hill, where I used to meet him for lunch. He loved it there. I know it's not consecrated ground. But what could I do?
God will understand. I buried Ma and Pa under the linden tree by our house. It's what they would have wanted.
Yes. Father and Stibor are buried in the churchyard in Rovna.
Once things settle, we'll be able to go back and pay our respects and get the priest to bless their graves. I have no more questions. Thank you for telling me about everything, Teresa. I know it isn't easy to talk about.
It helped to talk to someone who knows what it's like. Thank you. I'm glad you came out of it in one piece.
Yeah, so am I. And I'm glad you did, too.
By the way, Henry, I have something for you. The soldiers gave it to me when we brought you from Skalitz. I meant to give it to you earlier, but, you know, it belonged to one of the Skalitz garrison. They wanted me to have it for being brave, but I hope I'll never have use for such a thing.
Oh? How come? What is it?
It's a shield with the Skalitz crest. I'd like you to have it.
Oh, cool.
To protect you and as a keepsake from home.
Sure.
It's actually really sweet.
Thanks, Teresa. Thanks for everything.
Yeah, that's going to be our shield then. Makes it really meaningful having it be a Skalitz one. Okay, it seems like all of them have the same stats, so it's not like we get more defense from this. So it's all cosmetic at that point. I can't really turn it around and look at it, but you can kind of see the look of it from the icon. Okay. I don't think we need any of this right now. So we'll just leave it.
Hey, lad! God be with you.
Is there any work here for carpenter?
I'm not looking for any.
Okay, so I wonder if his exclamation is about betting on the tourney?
Will you teach me how-
Certainly.
I'm interested in-
Wouldn't you rather-
Yeah, we're not there yet.
Well. I hear you're-
Certainly.
I'd like to hone my-
First you have to have-
Okay, once we get to 10.
Well.
God be with you.
Alright. Now the thing is that we might actually do the tourney this time. Also, how are we doing on schnapps? I think we're getting low, aren't we? Don't we only have like 2? Yeah, we only have 2. Okay. I truly have to try this again. And honestly, let's go ahead. I don't know if the game automatically saved when we finish the DLC, but let's just go ahead and make sure that it saves. And I think I'm going to try and make Save Your Schnapps again. Wow, it's almost evening. Didn't realize we were that far into the day today. We're also going to be probably trying that bandit camp quest somewhat soon, go and kill the bandit leader. I think we might be strong enough to be able to do that. If it's a big camp full of people, I don't know how many people are going to be there, then it might be really hard, so we might not be able to do it, but we're relatively close to it right now. Shoot, I wonder if we're even going to make it before they close. Now, we weren't able to get this guy to give us a tutorial, which I honestly don't even remember if there... I'm pretty sure there was someone somewhere that gave us an alchemy tutorial, but maybe I'm wrong. Honestly, I might just have to, like, watch a video on it or something, because it is a little bit complicated. But if I remember correctly, we can go around the side to access the alchemy table. Is that true? Is it here? No, it might be down lower. Am I making this up? No, I think it is here. Yep, okay. Alright, so we've saved. Now we need to try this again. Man, I wish there was a little bit more brightness here. Okay. Prepare the wine. 2 handfuls of belladonna, 1 of nettle. Boil nettle for 2 turns, grind the belladonna. Can I do the pre-prep for like the grinding and stuff right now? Hold on, if I go here, then I can hold E to prepare. Oh, we don't have the stuff because it's on our horse. So we need wine. Actually, I should try and see if we even need the wine ourselves or if it's just provided at the table. So, in my inventory, I don't have any wine on me. So let's try it that way. And we need nettle and belladonna. Keep on trying to do E to transfer. It's X. Okay. Oh, there are multiple pages. Here we go. Okay, this might help us, actually. The degree of difficulty of the brewing itself varies, and each recipe requires a variable number of steps. The first step is always to pour the potion base, which you will find on the shelf to your left, which we don't have to provide ourselves, it seems like. Then add the ingredient to the cauldron from the shelf on the right. If the recipe demands it, you must take care to grind ingredients using the mortar and pestle. You can use the dish next to the mortar and pestle to prepare these ingredients. The next step is to brew the mixture on the prescribed flame, which is regulated by means of the bellows. Sometimes it's enough just to warm it on low heat. Sometimes it has to be boiled, so you have to work the bellows until the mixture bubbles. You must carefully time how long you brew the potion using the sand glass, F. The brewed potion can then be poured directly from the cauldron into the phial or passed through the distiller. Into the phial. Do we need a phial or is the phial just somewhere on the table? The recipe steps must be adhered to precisely. If you deviate too much from them, the potion will fail. You'll lose all your ingredients, and the whole brewing process will have to be repeated. So there's the still, but where's the phial? Alright, that's what I kind of like got lost on last time, but... Alright. Read. Prepare. Now we need 2 things of belladonna. See, it doesn't let you, like, pre-prep this in the mortar. I don't know why. That's really frustrating. Like, how am I supposed to get, like, the timing of these things perfect when I can't have everything prepped to just throw in, you know? I don't know if I'm gonna be fast enough. Yeah, it just won't let you use them. Alright, if we start with the wine. Okay, now we've got our base. Now can I prep this stuff? Belladonna, and this is the one that requires 2. Yep. Nope, he just put it back. There we go. Okay. Don't know what the dish is for. Just put it down, bro. It's prepped, fine. Alright, that's frustrating. So you kind of have to... I think you have to go... No, we can put it in the dish then. You can prep it. Okay. That's what the dish is for. Okay. So let's just make sure. So grind the Belladonna, yep. Boil nettle for 2 turns. Drop in the Belladonna, boil for 1 more turn. I'm gonna get it to boil first. I don't know if you can overboil. Okay, I'm just trying to look at everything. Okay, so that's the file. As long as we didn't overdo it there, we should have a Savior Schnapps. We did it. We did it. We did it. All right, we can make several of these right now. Okay, boom. There we go. All right, first time successfully doing alchemy. Hell yeah. All right. Boom. Now, if it takes 2 Belladonna for each of these, we can make 6 more. So as long as we're successful, we can make 6 more Savior Schnapps. Which would make me feel real good about myself. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and end the episode here. And in the next one, I think we're going to start off by making as many Savior Schnapps as we can. It seems like we did alright there, so... not bad. But yeah, thank you all for being here. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And in the next episode, we will make some more Savior Schnapps. Have a good one, everybody. Bye.
I'd like to give a very special shout out to my patron supporters, Darren York, ZTD, Chris Murphy, JW, Quinless, Vlado101, Bruce Wizard, Black Mamba 90, Eureka Gecko, The Happy Fat Panda, Pato Kuto, Shadow Raven, Anna Kate the Great, Emily Kuzanova, Philip Dowd, Timothy Jansen, Skip, Danny, Yell, Naya, TurkeyFoot27, and Nadia N. If you would also like to join this tier or any others, check out my memberships or my Patreon in the description down below.